So in this video we will see the calculation of plastering, that is internal plastering. So internal plastering like ceiling plaster and wall plaster. So in this also we have to do the deductions. So wherever we are getting the openings, so in that cases we have to do the deductions. So we should be careful when we are doing the deductions, because we have to do in some cases two sides deduction we have to do. In some cases we have to do only one side deduction. So let us see that. So next item of work is internal plastering. So this is for ceiling and walls. Ceiling and walls we have to calculate. First of all we will see ceiling plaster. So in case of ceiling plaster, so first of all we have to write the rooms, so kitchen, hall, bedrooms, toilets and all. So let me write the rooms, kitchen, bedroom 1, 3, these are all the rooms along with passages. So first one is kitchen. So kitchen, how many kitchens are there? Only one kitchen. Bedrooms, here I have separated bedroom 1, 3 is 1, that is total 2 rooms, and bedroom 2 is 1, I'll explain you, and hall or dining is 1, and in case of toilets it is 3 numbers, passage 1, passage 2 is also 1. So directly we have to take the internal dimensions of rooms. So for kitchen, what are the internal dimensions? 3.0 by 2.8 meter. So there will not be any depth, because we have to multiply only length and breadth. Now coming to bedroom 1, 3. So this is bedroom 1 and this is bedroom 3. So these two I have taken as 1 and bedroom 2 as separate, because extra space is there in this bedroom 2. So for this also we have to calculate the plastering area. So for this one, 4 meter by 4 meter, 4.0 4.0, there will not be any depth. Now coming to bedroom 2, there are two parts. So this part is one part and this part is another part. So part 1 plus part 2 we have to do. So for part 1, how much we are getting? So P1 is equal to 4 into 4, this direction 4 meters, this direction 4 meter, so it is 16 square meters. Now coming to this one, how much we will get? This is 1.2 meter, so this is 1.2 and this is 1.63. so how much we are getting? 1.2 into 1.63, so I got 1.956. P2 is equal to 1.956. So addition of part 1 and part 2, so I got, so directly I will write it here, I got the quantity as 17.956 square meters. Okay, so this part I have taken as 1 and this part I have taken as 2. Addition of these two will be our answer. Now coming to hall or dining. So in case of hall or dining, I'll take this part, only this part. So horizontal dimension it is 4 and vertical dimension it is 8.66. 4.0 8.66, there will not be any depth. Now coming to toilets. So three toilets are there of size 2.6 meter by vertical it is 1.4 meter. 2.6, 1.4 and depth is nothing. So coming to passage, all the rooms are covered except this is passage 1. So here and here, this box is one passage and this part is left over. So I am considering this as passage 1, passage 2. So in case of passage 1, what are the dimensions? This dimension is 1.2 and this dimension is 3.03. 1.2, 3.03. Now coming to passage 2. Here this distance is 1 meter and vertical it is 2.8 meter. So 1.0, 2.8 and this is nothing. So let us see the plastering area. 3 into 2.8 meter. I got 8.4 meter square multiplied by 1. 8.4 meter square. Now next one is bedroom 1 and 3. It is 4 into 4 is 16. 16 into 2 is 32. 16 meter square multiplied by 2 is 32 meter square. And this one will be same, 17.956 meter square. Next one is hall or dining. So 4 into 8.66. So I got 34.64 meter square multiplied by 1 meter square. Now next one is toilets, 2.6 into 1.4, 3.64 meter square multiplied by 3 numbers. So here I got 10.92 meter square. Next one is passage 1, 1.2 into 3.03. So I got 3.636 meter square multiplied by 1, 3.636 meter square. Next one is 2.8. It will be 2.8 meter square multiplied by 1. So this is total 2.8 plus 3.636 plus 10.92 plus 34.64 plus 17.956 plus 32 plus 8.4. Here I got 110.352 meter square. So this is complete ceiling plaster. So that means from this end to this end, this end to this end, this one and this one, complete ceiling plaster is covered. So here generally we will take 1:3 or 1:4 mixed proportion for cement mortar. Now our second part is walls, which are internal. So we will calculate internal wall plastering. So same rooms will be there. So kitchen will be as it is, passage 1. Here I am not writing passage 2 because I will include this complete wall surface area in hall only. Directly I will include like this. So here in case of kitchen, same numbers 1, 2, 1, 1, 3 and 1. So what are the dimensions? Here internal dimensions are 3 meter by 2.8 meter. So what we have to do? We are doing the plastering for wall surfaces. So these surfaces. So what we have to do? We have to calculate in the formula 2 into L plus B. That is nothing but perimeter length. So 2 into 3 plus 2.8. This should be our length. So in similar way, we have to write for all. So 2 into 3 plus 2.8. So here I got 11.6 meters. Similarly for bedroom. So here 4 plus 4. I got 16 as the perimeter length. Now coming to bedroom 2. Here what we have to do? We have to calculate the complete perimeter length of this one. So how we will calculate? Directly I will take this length, this length, this length and this length, and I will add this part and this part. So let us see how much we will get. So perimeter is 16 for that one, plus 1.63 into two sides, 1.63 into 2. I got 19.26. 19.26 is the complete perimeter length, this one. Now coming to hall or dining. So similar way, I have to calculate the complete surfaces. How much we will get? This is 4 meter. Plus this complete one is 8.66, plus from here to here it is 5 meter, and from here to here it is 2.8 meter, and this is 1 meter, plus remaining is this one. So how to calculate this length? So total 8.66 minus this part 2.8, so 5.86 I got. So 5.86 plus 1 plus 2.8 plus 5 plus 8.66 plus 4, I got 27.32 is the complete perimeter length, this one. So now next one is toilets. Toilet length is 2.6 plus 1.4. 2.6 plus 1.4, I got 4 into 2 is 8. So this complete perimeter is 8 and 3 numbers. Now coming to the passage 1. So this is passage 1, this is passage 2 in this case, but this I already covered. So here what I will do, this is 1.2 and this is 3.03.
3.03 plus 1.2, 4.23 into 2. Here I got 8.46. So these are all perimeter lengths of this wall surfaces. Now what I have to do? I have to multiply this length, complete perimeters, with height of walls. Here there will not be any breadth because we are calculating the wall plaster. So we have to take this length and multiply with height. So here no need of any breadth. Now what I will do? What is the height of complete ceiling? So here if you see, from top of plinth beam to bottom of slab level. So what is the total vertical length? It is 3 meters. So directly I'll write 3 meters. This is for plastering purpose. So directly we have to multiply length into height of the wall. So 11.6 into 3. 34.8 meter square multiplied by 1, 34.8 meter square. Second one is 16 into 3 is 48 meter square multiplied by 2 numbers, because 2 rooms are there, 96 meter square. So these are the internal wall plastering areas. So if we add this, so what will be our total? So 34.8 plus 96 plus 57.78 plus 81.96 plus 72 plus 25.38. So here I got 367.92 meter square. So this is wall plastering area and this is ceiling plaster. So if we add these two, how much we will get? Plus 110.352. So it is total 272 meter square. This is without deduction. So total internal plastering area which we got is 478.272 square meters. So for this we have to do the deductions also. So deductions are nothing but wherever we are getting openings like doors, windows, ventilators and arches. So in that cases we have to do the deductions. In case of deductions, we should be very careful. We should do proper deductions. So let us see that. So in case of deductions in internal plastering, so we have to minus this one. So here, what are the openings here? Main door, door 1, door 2, and next one is arch, window 1, kitchen window, ventilator. So these are all the openings which are coming across the internal wall plastering area. Now if you see the main door size, so let us write the numbers first. Main door is 1, door 1 are 4, door 2 are 3, arch is 1, windows are 5, kitchen window 1 and ventilators are 3. So now we will write the lengths. 1.5 meter is the main door horizontal dimension. There will not be any breadth. Directly we have to write the height of the opening. Now coming to door 1, 1.2, 2.1, door 2, 0.8, 2.1. Now coming to arch, 1.4, 2.1, window 1, 1.5, 1.2. Coming to kitchen window, 1.2, 1.2. Ventilators, 0.6, 0.3. So these are the opening dimensions. Now what we have to do? We have to find out the area of opening. 1.5 into 2.1. So 3.15 meter square. This is for only one side. Next is 1.2 into 2.1. So 2.52 meter square. 0.18 meter square. Now coming to total quantity, we should be very careful in numbers. This is most important. So for main door, one side is internal, one side is external side. So this side plastering will be there, this side plastering will be there. So this is internal one, this is external plastering. So one door into only one side we have to deduct. Now coming to door 1, these doors are internal doors, so we should take the internal plastering deduction for all these doors, door 1, door 1, door 1, door 1. For this one, this is also internal, this is also internal. So this side we have to deduct, this side we have to deduct. So two times. So door 1, for this one two times. So total 4 number of doors are there. Into for each door, two sides we have to deduct because it comes under internal plastering. Coming to door 2, so this also internal door only, 1, 2, 3. 3 doors into two sides. Coming to arch, this is also internal only, this side,
arch into two windows. Five windows are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For this windows, one side is internal, one side is external. So we have to consider only one time for this one because we are doing the calculation for internal only. So internal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So total 5 doors are there. Only one side we have to deduct. Coming to kitchen window. One side is outside, one side is inside. So into 1. Ventilators. So into 1 because one side is outside, one side is inside. So similarly into 1. So what will be the total? 3.15 into this one. So 1. Answer will be same 3.15 meter square. Next one is 2.52 into 4 into 2 is 8. So 8 times we have to deduct 20.16 meter square. Next one is 1.68 into this one 6. 10.08 meter square. Next one is 2.94 into 2 times 5.88 meter square. Next one is 1.8 into 5 9 meter square. Next one is 1.44 into 1 1. Meter square. 0.18 into 3 into 1 is 3 numbers. 0.54 meter square. What will be the total? This is for deduction. So 50.25 meter square. So this is the plastering area which we need to deduct for complete internal plastering area. So from this we have to deduct. So total we got as 478.27 minus this one 50.25. So this should be our answer. 478.272 minus 50.25. 428.022 meter square. So this is the plastering area after deduction. So after deduction I got this as the plastering area. So this is how we will calculate the internal plastering area. Now in a similar way we will see the complete outer plastering area. So that is external plastering area. External plaster. So in case of external plaster, what I will do, directly I will take the length from this end to this end and this end to this end. Already it is written here, this one and this one. 8.69 is the outer complete length and 14.98 is the outer complete length. So here external area is equal to, directly I'll write numbers as 1 and 8.69 plus 14.98 into 2. I got 47.34 as complete perimeter length. So complete perimeter length is 47.34. No need of any breadth here. Directly I have to write the height of this complete structure. So from ground level to top of this one, what is the total height? So directly from plinth beam I am taking.
bottom of plinth beam. So 1 meter, this is 1 meter plus 0.15 plus 3 meters plus 0.23. So I got 4.38 meters as the complete height for external plastering. So 4.38 multiplied by 47.34. I will get the area as 207.34 meter square multiplied by 1. So 207.34 meter square. So this is the complete external plastering area. So from bottom of plinth beam to top of parapet level I have taken. Now for this one I have to add this parapet level. So this is parapet. Parapet internal side also we have to do. So for this complete one, parapet inside. Inside parapet we have to do parapet top side also. So for this top side we have to do. So 2 times we have to calculate. So I'll take directly as 1. So inside of parapet means this is 230 mm wall. Half of this 230 mm is 0.115 mm. So directly I have taken the center to center dimension. So this is the center dimension from here to here. So directly I will take this length, center to center length, and this center to center length. So 8.46 plus 14.75 into 2. So I got 46.42 meter, and height of this parapet wall is 1 meter from here to here. Here you can see it is given as 1 meter. So directly I will write 1.0. So 46.42 into 1 will be the same 46.42, and in total also 46.42 meter square. So internal side of parapet is over. Now we have to calculate the top side. So in case of top side, so if this is the parapet wall, in top view we can see like this. So this is top side of parapet. Okay, now to get the parapet top area, what I'll do for this parapet wall, again I'll take the center to center dimension. How I'll get the center to center dimension? This out to out it is 8.69 meters. So I can take the average of these two also. If I take the average of this one and this one, I will get the center line to these two lines. If I take the average of this one and this one, I will get the center to these two lines. So directly we will take like that, 8.69 plus 8.64. So that divided by 2, 8.665. So 8.665 I got here. Next one is 14.75 plus 14.98 divided by 2. So this side from center to center I got 14.865.
So this wall thickness is 0.115 meter. Make sure this is 0.115 thickness wall. So now how much I will get? 14.865 plus 8.665 into 2. 47.06 is the total centerlined perimeter length at top. Now what I have to do, there will not be any depth here, but I have to write breadth 0.115. So length into breadth will be the top area. 47.06 multiplied by 0.115. So here I'll get 5.4119 meter square. So this is the top area of the parapet. So now what I will do, I will add all this. Total is equal to 207.34 plus 46.42 plus 5.4119. So I got 259.1719 square meters. So this is the complete external plastering area. Now for this, what I have to do? I have to do the deductions. So what kind of deductions again? So this is main door, outside this opening should be deducted. This is window 1, this should be deducted, this should be deducted, this should be deducted, this should be deducted. So similarly, same like this one, but this internal doors will not be covered here. So in case of deductions, what we have to do? So this main door is touching outer surface, so 1.5 meter. Next one is, this window is touching external surface, so window 1. Next one is, ventilator is touching kitchen window and ventilator. So door 1 is not touching the external surface, door 2 is not touching the external surface, arch is not touching the external surface. So here these 4 are touching the external surfaces. Now what I have to do? So in case of main door, what is the size? 1.5 by 2.1. window 1 is 1.5 by 1.2. in case of kitchen window, 1.2 by 1.2. in case of ventilator, 0.6 by 0.3. so main door is 1, windows are 5, kitchen window is 1, ventilators are 3. So in length directly I will write 1.5 2.1. so 1.5 1.2 1.2 1.2 0.6 0.3. so here again, in case of deductions we should be more careful. So main door is 1, we have to deduct only one side. So windows are 5, we have to deduct only one side. Kitchen window, one window into one side we have to deduct, because other side already we have done. Ventilators also same. So here what will be our answer? 1.5 into 2.1, so 3.15 meter square. 1.5 into 1.2, 1.8 meter square. 1.2 into 1.2, 1.44 meter square. Next one is 0.6 into 0.3 0.18. we have to multiply these all with
this one. So everything will be same, almost 3.15 into this we have to do only once. So this remains same, 3.15 meter square. Here 1.8 into 5 numbers, so it is 9 meter square. Next one is 1.44 into 1 number, so it will be same. Next one is 0.18 into 3 numbers, so 0.54 meter square. What is the total? 3.15 plus 9 plus 1.44 plus 0.54, so 14.13 meter square. So this is the deduction quantity for external plastering. So this is without deduction, this is the deduction we need to do. So 259.1719 minus 14.13, so our external blasting will be 245.0419 meter square. So this is our answer, 245.0419 meter square. So this is our external plastering area. So I hope you understood. This is very simple. If you try to understand, it is very easy. So if you are having any doubts, you can comment in the comment section so that I can respond your comments. And if you are watching this channel for the first time, do subscribe, and if you like the video, hit the like button. So we'll continue in the next video.